So, I made another video. It's been a while. Been doing things like music stuff and traveling and whatever else. Fucking shit. I don't know. But, yeah, I felt like I needed to make another one, and I made another Mono Machine video because everybody seemed to like that, and also because there's so much to do on the Mono Machine. I just want to explore and show people what I like to do with it. So, yeah, I did that. It's kind of a bit more ambient this time, although for me that's still going to be quite rhythmic with a lot of the, especially with like the FM sounds and stuff. But that's okay. It's more ambient. It's slower. It's a different vibe. I'm going for something different because I felt like I had to do something different for another video. Don't know what else to say about it. I think that's pretty much it. Oh, there's less talking as well, although I realize I'm talking now. But there's just a lot of kind of doing. Anyway, that's it. I hope you enjoy it. Let me know what you think. All that sort of shit. Subscribe, whatever. Thanks. Bye. I've got a new kit. Completely blank. Everything's set fresh, so I'm just gonna start on this first track. And I'm gonna select right off the bat, I'm gonna go right down to the deep row and select the ensemble wave. And I'm just gonna put in some trigs. I'm just gonna do that. At the moment, it's just on a sine wave and turn the volume up a bit. So this is one cool thing about the Mono Machine that I mentioned in my last video is just the sub. You can hear that. Like, and if I go to the effects and I use the EQ. Like I'm almost tempted not to do anything else to this. Like, even though this is an ensemble machine, which means I can make chords out of it, I'm kind of just tempted to leave this. But let's see what else we can do. What I'm also going to do is turn the tempo right down. Well, not right down, but you know, down. I'm going to bring in another note. We're going to go back down to the EQ and turn that off. Look how much difference that makes. I might turn it back up again. Fact, I might even set an LFO to do that. I go to the effects, yep, and the frequency. I'll turn the speed down a bit. Almost gives it a bit of a flanging quality. I like that. I'm gonna go here and I'm gonna turn the delay up. So I already quite like that a lot. I don't even know if I'm gonna touch any of that, any more than that, like. I know it's super basic, but I just think it kind of works. So let's start on a new track. Still got this going. I might actually load up another deep row machine. This time I might just go to the wave, the basic one. My yes key is a little, or my enter key is a little bit sticky. So, turn the volume up on that. That sounds awful, but it won't for very long. Thank you. sounding pretty sweet. I'm just gonna move on to another track, but I might mute this for a little bit and come up with something slightly different. So we still just got that. I might bring in some trigs on this one, just randomly. It's just set to the sine wave at the moment, but I'm gonna load in another machine. Thank you.
So that's sounding pretty fucking sweet. What I'm going to do with this, though, is I'm going to... Because I've sort of already talked a lot through the Mono Machine in the last video, but I don't think I talked a huge amount through making an effects track. So I'm just going to go down here to the effects page. That's not what I wanted. And I'm going to put a reverb on this, but you've got a bunch of other things as well. So the reverb takes a little bit of tweaking, but it's actually pretty sweet. And the way you've got to do it is I've got to actually go back to this other track and I've got to send it to a bus by going over here and I'm going to send it to bus CD. And then on this one, I'm going to do input rather than, well, neighbor just means it's going to go from the track above, which is actually a pretty good thing because that's the one I want. But for flexibility's sake, I'm going to do it to bus CD, which means I can add it, any other track to it as well. So I'm just going to go like that. And then, one thing that's kind of a weird thing about electron machines is you have to put a trig on an effects track so that it actually starts playing. And you also have to turn all of these up so that the track never stops, so it's always open. And the reason is because if you send the audio from this track into this one, you can still affect it with envelopes and all of the filters and everything. So that's why they do it. You know, you could have the track being sent in and have a filter envelope sort of from this trig fading, even though the sound is full on the other track. So there are reasons why you might want to use that. But for this one, I'm just going to have it all open just so it can be a reverb. And if we press play, I'm going to mute these other ones. Press play. You can already hear it. So I think this track at the beginning, the first one I worked on, I think it needs a bit of beefing up. So the way I'm going to do that is I'm just going to copy the entire track down to this guy, the bottom, the last track. So now they're both playing. But what I'm going to do on this one is I'm just going to change the waveform. And I'm going to add another pitch. And a bass pitch. That's totally distorting now because of the filtering. Oh no, because of the EQ. So I'm going to turn the EQ off. I'm going to go back to this page. I might actually... Yeah, so I want a bit of a bass bed. So we're going to turn it down slightly. There we go. I've decided that I want this FM track to also go through the reverb, so I'm just going to go to the edit page and put the CD on that one as well. There you go. Everything about this, except for this track. The melody is fine, but it's a bit busy and stuff, so I'm just gonna clear it and I'm gonna start again. that's pretty much all I'm going to do today. I'll probably make another video very soon, but that's all the tracks I've got. I've run out of tracks. On this track, I've got this, this sound, which is married to this sound. And I've got this little, sort of slightly wavetable-y melody up here. And down here, FM going into this reverb, along with this bass synth, which is also going into it. That's it. That's it for today. A bit low energy on this day, but I made that, and I made it in like 20 minutes. So I hope you fucking like it. I'll make another video soon. Thanks. See ya.